Hey, I'm KB Kwan. Welcome back to another episode of Taste of Asian Food. Today, I'm going to show you how to prepare a traditional Malaysian cuisine called Ayam Pongteh, which is a Nyonya cuisine. So, a few decades ago, the Chinese people come to Peninsula Malaysia to look for fortune, and eventually they settle in Malaysia. And eventually they start to, you know, marry the local girls, which are Malay, and the offspring start to develop the very unique cuisine called Nyonya cuisine. Ayam Pongteh is a combination of Malay and Chinese cooking. And in this recipe, Ayam Pongteh, Ayam means chicken. So this is a chicken potato stew. And it is in fact pretty similar to the traditional Chinese chicken stew with potatoes, but with plenty of garlic and shallots and one very important ingredient, the Malacca sugar, that is a palm sugar, gula Malacca. In this video, I'm going to show you how to prepare this chicken stew, Ayam Pongteh. Over here, I have chicken thighs, about 1 kilogram, skin on, bone in. You can use chicken breast meat or chicken thigh without the bone, but bone will deliver the extra flavor during stewing. You may want to marinate the chicken with some light soy sauce if you have time, but this is entirely optional. It will be useful to marinate it if you want to eat it immediately after cooking. But if you do not marinate the chicken, but then wait for half a day or even overnight before you serve, the flavor from the gravy during stewing should then be able to penetrate deep into the meat of the chicken. So marinade is really an optional step. Next, prepare some shallot and some garlic. Rough chop the garlic and shallot. Then ground it with a mortar and pestle or with a food processor. I prefer to use a food processor because it is more convenient. We also need some potatoes cut into chunks about 1 inch in length, and remove the skin if you want, and keep in water, soak in water if you do not use it immediately to avoid being oxidized. And also some Chinese dry shiitake mushroom, put it in water and soak it until it is fully hydrated. It will then look like this, fully hydrated. Then cut them into slices. I have one still not cut it yet. Okay, that way, cut it into two or three. And lastly, another important ingredient is the palm sugar. We need about 2 to 3 tablespoons of palm sugar. If you do not have palm sugar, you can use brown sugar as the substitute. about 2 tablespoons. Okay. So these are the ingredients required for chicken pongteh: the chicken, the potatoes, dry shiitake mushroom, soak and rehydrate, garlic and the shallots, some palm sugar. And some people will also like to add some spices. The common spices that is used is star anise and also cinnamon. And today I want to make it simple, so I'm not going to add these two, but if you like the flavor of these spices, please by all means add into your recipe. And the seasoning used is also quite simple: light soy sauce, some dark soy sauce, and some fermented soybean paste, which is also called Taucu. Let's begin the cooking process by deep frying the potatoes. These are the potatoes that I have already removed from water, and then put it on a piece of dry cloth to keep it dry before deep frying. Deep fry the potatoes serve two purposes. First, it helps to develop more flavor. Secondly, it firms up the potatoes so that during stewing, the potatoes will not break or disintegrate that easily. If you are concerned about there's too much oil or you do not like deep frying, you can always add the potatoes to the chicken straight away and stew them together straight away without deep frying the potatoes. Once the potatoes have changed color slightly, remove the potatoes from the oil. Let's remove most of the oil from the wok and then use some oil to saute the garlic and the shallot. When the color has changed to slightly darker and starts to release an aromatic flavor, then add the seasoning, the light soy sauce, some dark soy sauce, and the Taucu, which is also called fermented yellow bean paste. You can refer the recipe below the video for the quantity of each ingredient that I use. Now add the chicken and mix well. And also add some water. As well as the potatoes. Also the mushroom that I have soaked, cut and rehydrate. They need a little bit more water. Then the palm sugar. Adjust by adding some more dark soy sauce to make the colors more slightly darker. Now just turn down the heat to the lowest possible, cover it and let it stew for about 20 minutes or until the chickens are cooked and the potatoes are soft. I've cooked the chicken for about 17 minutes. Let's take a look whether it is already fully cooked. You can use a kitchen thermometer if you want. Yep, it's already reached about 80 degrees Celsius, so it is done. And I'm not going to continue cooking it because I'm going to keep the chicken juicy and soft and tender. Meanwhile, do a taste test to see if I need to make any adjustment of the taste. It is just okay, no need to change. The combination of sweetness and saltiness is just perfect. Okay, we have just finished making the Ayam Pongteh, which is so different because it is sweet as well as savory. We use the palm sugar, which is primarily used in Malay cooking, and also the Taucu, which is primarily used in Chinese cooking. So it is a combination and we have the best of both. That's how to make chicken pongteh, the Nyonya style chicken stew with potatoes, and I hope you will love it. And as usual, I've included the recipe in the description below the video. Please subscribe, tap the notification and give me a thumbs up, and I'll see you again in some other similar video soon. Bye for now.